Hey guys, this is Manny from Poppy's Garage. We're here next to both of our 6x6 builds. Today we're gonna talk about all the details that these trucks come with. The front suspension on this Ram is gonna be what you guys will be getting in these trucks. It's gonna be a full bolt-on front suspension. This is a bolt-on truss that we designed. It's gonna come together to hold the front axle to our four-link that's going to our center cradle. It's gonna be using an upgraded steering system. Everything's gonna be 1¼-inch Heim. Then there's gonna be 7/8 Heims putting together all of the linkages for that front suspension. You're gonna have dual steering stabilizers as well, and then here you're gonna also be seeing our adjustable sway bar and our SS8 bags that are holding the front end together. Here in the Chevy, you're gonna be able to notice that there's actually a welded on truss onto this front diff. This front diff starts life as a Dana 60. Chevy originally makes these with a leaf sprung setup, so we actually have to convert a leaf sprung front towards a four-link front. This is why this is a little bit more unique, but this is just to show you guys that no matter what type of truck it is, no matter what suspension it already comes with, we can still convert it to have a four-link to match the rear setups that we're doing on these 6x6s. Our front four links start life from the center cradle. Most of these trucks are gonna have a center cradle that we make that either work as a skid plate on the Chevy or on the Dodge itself is actually the tranny cross member. From here, you're gonna have your four link bars that are going to the front, and they're also gonna be able to see your sway bar and how our front suspension actually begins. So our driveline stays as a single driveline down the center of the truck. The trick to that is the SCS transfer case that we use that's bolted to that front pinion flange of the primary 14 bolt. That SCS gearbox allows us to have one single driveline down the middle, which allows for a lot less vibration, almost no vibration at the highway, and the truck to obtain highway speeds very comfortably. The gearbox is a one-to-one gearbox and handles just about all the power you want to slap at it, and that allows for both axles to be driven at all time, giving you true 6x6 capabilities. Our rear suspensions are going to be two parallel four links with track bars as well. We feature SS7 double bellow bags along with Radflow remote reservoir shocks. We use our limit straps, and this holds our whole rear suspension together. The reason that we picked these bags is for the towing capabilities. This truck now has a payload that's DOT compliant with basically the max tire load. We can technically handle more than that. We just can't advertise that we can handle more than that. As far as the stopping power for the rear suspension, both of the trucks are gonna feature Wilwood brakes to be able to stop each axle independently. Both of our rear axles commence life as a corporate 14 bolt center. It's gonna give you a nice big heavy duty ring gear. We actually add an ARB airlocker to both axles to lock both axles entirely. Both axles have our trusses welded on top of them. The DOM tubing that we use is 1/2-inch walls, and then we use Dana 60 inner C's to allow us to use Dana 60 knuckles for the steering. We use a PSC 8-inch ram to be able to steer the rear. The trucks feature whatever size tire you want. These two trucks right now have 42-inch tires. These are gonna be 42-inch Aturo mud trails. They're gonna be 15.5-inch wide. Both trucks have 24x14 super single rears and 24x8¼ dually fronts. The reason that we opt for a dually front is because we feel that the turning radius is gonna be a little bit better and you're not cutting the front bumper or into the fender for actual full steering. Trucks can feature any choice of wheel that you'd like. Here on the Dodge, you're gonna be able to see the DEF tank. We try to keep this here for this truck, and we relocate it on the Chevy. This truck starts life as a brand new truck, so we try to not touch any of the emission system or none of the engine onboard systems. We want this truck to contain all of its factory powertrain warranty. One of the best things that these trucks offer is that when we start with a Ram package, we actually buy a Laramie Limited truck. This is gonna be a stock truck with a 12-inch infotainment unit, full leather seats trimmed with the Laramie stitching. Everything is nice and matching from factory. It's gonna have power pedals, power everything. The only feature this truck doesn't have is gonna be a sunroof. It's the only feature not offered in a Laramie Limited when you buy a cabin chassis 5500 platform. All of the trucks that we build come with a flatbed or a regular bed that we can also make. These flatbeds that we make are 84 inches wide, a hair under 11 feet long. truck is gonna come with a hidden gooseneck section in the middle. It's also gonna come with the same tow rating capacity in the rear with your actual bumper mounted hitch. The beds feature full 14 gauge sides. The sides are shaped to have the same exact sheet metal contour as the cab itself. It's obviously gonna be about 3 inches wider on each edge. And the beds are full 1/8 inch diamond plate over the top, so you can just throw and slap whatever it is that you might want on top of the beds. In our management system, you're gonna notice that the wheels are constantly turning on the app. That is gonna be dictated by these potentiometers that were used as steering location sensors. There's gonna be one of those per axle, and that's gonna tell the management system exactly where it is that each of these axles is in correlation to all of them. So whenever you're in tight turn mode and you see that the front is turned left and the rears are turned right, that is the sensor that's responsible to keep you within a degree or two of that ratio that you're supposed to be in. When you first launch our application, you're gonna be prompted to connect to Bluetooth. Upon connection on Bluetooth, you're going to then select the steer page. In this page, you're going to be able to see everything that needs to be managed and controlled for all of the onboard automatic steering systems. The first thing you are going to see is three different driving modes. Normal mode, which keeps your rear axles perfectly straight at all times. When moving over to crab mode, you will quickly notice the rear axles will shift in the same direction as your front axle. As you turn your steering wheel and increase your steering angle, the rear axles will automatically turn to match the front steering angle. Now we'll slide over to tight turn mode. When in tight turn mode, the rear axles will automatically turn to counter steer your front steering angle. This will give the truck a tighter turn radius.